Hi guys, we are going to see today how we can change brake fluid in a Kia Picanto. It's a 2006 model, but it's the same procedure for about all Kia or all cars. This brake with ABS system, and we are going to need a plastic bottle, a hose 5 millimeters diameter, and also a syringe for removing the brake fluid from the brake tank. The first we have to do is to remove as much brake fluid we can from the brake tank. We have to remove first this small part, because we are going to put the syringe inside. And we are moving all the amount we can from the old brake fluid. But we put all this fluid in our bottle. You have to be careful, because this is dangerous for the eyes and our body. So we are keep doing this procedure until we remove all the brake fluid. Then we are closing the cap of our bottle. You see that the hose is inside, all the way down, inside the brake fluid. And now, my friends, we are filling up the brake tank with new brake fluids. Until the up point, as you see. But now we are going to change our brake fluid. As you see in this car, the ABS unit is in the space of engine from the driver side, the left side, under the brake pump. So we are going to start the brake fluid changing from the farthest wheel, which is the rear right wheel, because we have always to begin the brake fluid changing from the farthest wheel. We are going to need some person for pressing and leave the brake pedal. Now we are going to the rear wheel. You see here the caliper from our brake. And we are going first to get out this rubber cover. Also, we are going to use an 8 millimeter wrench. We are putting it in the bleeder, and then we are putting in the bleeder the hoses, which is in our bottle until the bottom. Now, my friends, we have to untie the bleeder, as you see, and we are put our helper to press and leave our brake pedal. As you see, whenever we are pushing the brake pedal, some amount of brake fluid coming out from our brake caliper. So we are keeping doing this procedure until all the old fluid coming out, and until we see in this hose that new and clear brake fluid coming out. As you see now, the new brake fluid, it's in the bottom of our bottle and have different color from the old one. Now we can close the bleeder again. We are sure now that we have no air bubbles in our system, but for being sure, we can make the procedure which we are doing for removing air from our brake line. We are put our helper to press three times our brake pedal and the fourth time keep the brake pedal pressed. While the brake pedal is pressing, we are open and close very quickly the bleeder, as you are going to see in your screen, open and close, and we are doing this procedure 2 or 3 times by pressing 3 times and the 4th time keep our pedal pressing, and we are very quickly open and close the bleeder for the air coming out. After that, we are sure we have no air in our brake line. We tightened once more the brake bleeder and we are putting the rubber seal. We can wash this part with water for the old brake fluid. And while we are doing this procedure, we have to make sure that we keep full our brake fluid tank, because we don't want to air coming in our brake line, so we are have to watch that our brake tank is full with brake fluid. After we are finished with the second rear wheel, then we are coming to the front wheel, to the farthest from our ABS unit, which is the front right wheel. We are putting the wrench in a bleeder and then the hose, and we are untied the bleeder and put our helper to press and leave the brake pedal. You see now the old brake fluid. And we are doing this until we see clear brake fluid coming out from our hose. Then we can tighten the bleeder, and we can also make the procedure for being sure that we have no air bubble in our brake line, which means we put our helper to 3 times press the pedal and the 4th time keep it pressed. And we are open and close quickly the air bleeder. We're doing that 2 or 3 times for being sure that we have no air in our system. After that, we get the hose out, we check our bleeder for tight, and we put the rubber seal. Also, we have to wash this place with clear water. And once more, we check the lever for being sure that the reserve tank of our brake fluid is full with brake fluid. Then, my friend, we are going to the last wheel, the front left wheel, and after that we are check the level in our brake fluid reserve tank, and we are putting brake fluid until the max line. You see here the max line. Then we are closing the cap, and now we are ready from changing our brake fluid. It's the same procedure for about all cars. Thank you very much for watching my video.